क्वेश्चन नंबर एट, यस क्वेश्चन नंबर एट डियर रीडर, पेज 56, साइलेंस एवरीवन। मोस्ट frequently asked questions in exams, write down what we are doing. At 1st January 2006, the fair value of plan assets was rupees 10,000. What is this 1st January 2006? Beginning. 1st January 2006 means fair value at the beginning. On 30th June 2006, see, therefore I simply made you write beginning and end. I did not make you write end of the year. On 30th Jan 2006, the plan paid benefits of 1900. Plan paid the benefits. Mohini, what will we do? Yes, I like plan paid and write plus. Means we have received it. So 1900 we will add, and unlike received contribution of 4900, right, minus above that, means we have further contributed 4900 during the year. On 31st December 2006, this is value at the end. The fair value of plan assets was 15,000 and the present value of defined benefit obligation was 14,792. This is the expected. Actuarial losses on the obligation for 2006, the reporting enterprise made the following estimates based on the market price of the day. Look at it now. Interest and dividend income after tax payable by the fund 9.25%. Realized and unrealized gains on plan assets after tax 3, administration cost 1. So expected rate of return is 10.25%. Now actually in college, they have taken it as 10%, because the reason why they are taking 10.25% is, suppose it's compounded. They have taken half year compounded. So suppose you receive 10% return. In the beginning of the year, the value is 100. 30th June, you receive return of 10%. How will you count it for 6 months? 100 into 10% into 6 by 12. That will come to 5. 100 into 10% into 6 by 12 will come to 5. So what will be the value on 30th June? 105. Then on 31st December, again you will receive 6 months interest, but compounded half yearly, means now you will receive this interest on 105. Does it come to 5.25? Yes. Total becomes 110.25. Therefore, they say the return is 10.25%. So practically, the return is only 10%, not 10.25%, but it is compounded half yearly. Means you receive interest on interest every 6 months. That is why the rate comes to 10.25%. Okay. But in practical, when we solve the examples, you need not go so much in detail. So you can directly take 10.25% as expected return and solve it. Okay. Calculate the expected and actual return on plan assets for the year ended 31/12/2006, and also calculate actuarial gains and losses to be recognized in the statement of profit and loss account. So let us make the same table what we discussed yesterday. Okay. First, you can give the table showing three things. We will show in the table: actual return, which is also called actuarial return, expected return, and actuarial gains or losses. Three things we are going to find: actual return, expected return, and actuarial gain or loss. Will you all make the columns? Now, listen everyone. Very first, how do we start? Yesterday we made the table. Fair value. How do we start? At the end. So as on 31/12/06. Read the question and tell me. Yes, third line. Do you all find 15,000 fair value on 31/12/06?
Yes.
Any confusions? After this, you have to try one question on your own. Any confusions? From that, we have to minus fair value at the beginning means as on 1106. That is 10,000. Write it in bracket. You have to minus it. Any confusions? Then what do we have to further minus? Contribution received by the plan. What is the contribution received by the plan? 4,900. Write it in bracket and add benefits paid by the plan. What are the benefits paid by the plan? 1900. So 15 minus 10, 5 minus 4900, 100 plus 1900, 2000?
Yes.
This 2000 is actual return or actuarial return. So actually you have received a return of rupees 2000. Actual benefit is 2000 and it's quite logical. 15,000 was the value at the end. Okay. How much was the value in the beginning? 10,900. And further you have invested 4,900. Contribution received by the plan means you have further contributed in this year 4,900. Value in the beginning was 10,000. Further you invested 4,900. Means what are your total investments? 14,900, and the value of that investment is 15,000 at the end of the year. So you receive capital appreciation of what amount? 100 rupees. Okay, further, you have this benefits paid by the plan means we have received, employer has received interest or dividend, something like that, of rupees 1900. So that is also your return. So in capital appreciation, there is a return of 100 plus you have received interest or dividend of 1900. So what is your actual return you are getting on the investment during the year? 2000. Any confusions? Raise your hand. All are clear up till here? Now we have to find the expected return. What did we expect? Okay. So expected return. Now how to count and understand it? As I said, in college they have issued a pamphlet with solution. So as such they have discussed 10% return instead of 10.25. It was 10.25 comes if it is compounded half yearly. But then so much of complication will not be in exams. So we will take 10.25% and solve it. But they have done the solution with taking 10%. In exams, they should not give you compounded half yearly. So you will directly take the return what is given in the calculation. So how do you find the expected return? How much did we invest? How much was the value in the beginning of the year? On that we will receive 10.25% for full year. Is it or not? On 10,000 we will receive 10.25% for full year. Now on 30th June, can you see that in between? Second sentence. On 30th June, further we invested 4,900 but we also received. So can I say net investment is 3,000 only? We are receiving interest of 1900 and we are investing 4900 means from our pocket we are investing only 3000 rupees. On that 3000, because we have invested on 30th June, we will receive interest for 6 months only. 10.25% for 6 months. But actually it should be counted 10% only for 6 months. In college, that is what they have done. Okay. But as I said, this much complication, otherwise many times it will be compounded quarterly, you will get confused. So you will take 10.25% and solve. So how will you count the return on 10,000? Will count 10.25% for full year. And on 3,000 will come 10.25% for 6 months. Raise your hand who is not clear with this. So let out 10,000 into 10.25%. Inner column 1025. And 4900 minus 1900. That is 3000 into 10.25% into 6 by 12. Okay, this 10,000 is on 1106 and this is on 3606. So here we are counting it for 6 months. What does that come to? 154. So 1179 is the expected return. Means we expect a return of 1179, but we actually got a return of 2000. So there is an actuarial gain of 821. Is it? That is actuarial gain. Positive means it's a gain. So these three things are asked in the question. Anyone having any doubt in this? All are clear with it? Now look at question number 12. Question number 12. The fair value of plan assets at the beginning and end of the year were 2800 and 3086 respectively. So you will start with fair value at the end, that is 3086 minus fair value at the beginning, that is 2800. The employer's contribution to the plan during the year, and then employer's contribution. They were, what will you do with the employer's contribution to the plan during the year 2090? Hari? Will add? Sorry, minus. Employer's contribution during the year will minus. Benefit payment to retirees were 320, so that we will add. Benefits paid by the plan we will add. Calculate the actuarial return on plan assets. Here expected return is not asked. Okay, and it's not given also. Like in the previous question, 10.25% expected rate of return was given. So here you have to count only up till actual return. Any confusion in this? Himalaya?
Yes, sir.
Okay with it. What is not asked? Gone. Who are you concentrating? Which one? Camera. From camera home. On me here concentrating. Is you are looking at me through the camera? Directly I will look. Is everyone clear with this? Start solving it. Yes, we are in the question 12. Fair value at the end is. How much? 3086 minus fair value at the beginning is 2800. Okay. Then contribution received by the plan is 290 and benefit paid by the plan is 320. So
3 1 6.
This is the actual up till here only you have to find. Okay. One more question, number 16A. See that. Now you'll understand the reason why we did not take 10%. Practically, we would have counted 10%. On opening value, you should have counted 10.25%. On 30th June, you would have counted 10% for 6 months. But why we did not do it? See this. Question 16A. As on 1st April 2011, the fair value of plan assets was 2,50,000. Himalaya, what is that? Fair value at the beginning. In respect of pension plans of VIP Limited. On 30th September 2011, the benefits and then plan paid out So, Rajeshwari. Yes, market has plus 47,500. And receive further contribution of 120 to 500, Priyank. Yes, market has minus. Contributions received will minus, benefits paid will add. On 31st March 2012, the fair value of plan assets was 375,000. Fair value at year. Actuarial losses on the obligation for the year 11 and 12 were 1500. Actuarial losses were given as 1500 already. Ignore that, we are supposed to find it. On 1st April 2011, the company made the following estimates based on the market price on that date. So interest rate, dividend 9.25, realized and unrealized gain 2, minus administrative cost 1, expected rate of return. So on what value will you count 10.25% for full year, Ayushi? On what value will you count 10.25% for full year? What is the value in the beginning of the year? So 2,50,000, where did 15,000 come? What is the value at the beginning of the year? 2 lakh, on 2,50,000 you'll count 10.25% for full year. And doubt in this? And Dushyant, on which value will you count for 6 months? 120 to 500 minus 47,500. We received 120 to 500, means we invested, minus we received 47,500. So what is the net investment from our pocket? 75,000. Once again, on what value will you count 10.25% for whole year? Beginning value 2,50,000. On what value will you count for 6 months? September 30th September means October to March. Here this is financial year, this was calendar year January to December, this is April to March. So 30th September what we are receiving is 47,500. What we are investing is 120 to 500. What is our net investment on 30th September? 75,000. So October to March, for 6 months you'll count on 75,000. Then also calculate the actuarial gain or loss to be recognized in statement of profit and loss. Now underlying interest is compounded annually. That's why in the previous example also I took 10.25%. Like this you would take if it is compounded half yearly. Then on 2,50,000 you would count 10.25% for whole year. And on the 6 months interest you would have counted 10% for 6 months. But that complication will never come at me counted. So you do it at this way only as we discussed. On 2,50,000 10.25% for full year. And on 75,000 10.25% for 6 months. Start solving. Do you want me to solve them in the class? They are exactly similar. So, and they are hardly 5 minutes job. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 minutes. Yes, all have completed this. 16A. Check your answers. Fair value at the end. Fair value at the end of the year is 3,75,000. Beginning of the year minus 2,50,000. Contribution received further we have invested 120 to 500. Benefits paid by the plan. So we have received interest and dividend of 47,500. Means the actual return is 50,000. Now on 1/4/11, on 2,50,000 we will count 10.25% for whole year. So 25,000 and 625. And on 30th September what we are investing, 120 to 500 minus 47,500. Pay attention. 120 to 500 minus 47,500. Our net investment is 75,000 into 10.25% for 6 months. 3,844. Total investment is 2,9469. So gain of 20531. Is everyone clear with this? So this is your homework. They all are exactly similar. Right? Yes, I told about the SYB comp semester 4 pamphlets. Who has got it? You said last time you have it.